So what's up, guys? So in this video, I didn't really have much planned. You know, sometimes, like I said, there's weeks where news is a little bit slower than usual, and I tried looking for something, couldn't really find it. I was gonna elaborate more on the Umpqua Community College thing, but I think I'm going to save that update video for another video that will probably either has already been released or will be released if I choose to do that. But basically, just in case, you know, you didn't catch my last video or you've been living under a rock this week, I believe it happened on Thursday or Friday, where a 20-year-old gunman shot, I think his name was Chris Mercer or something like that. Anyway, he shot 13 people, he shot and killed 13 people and, like, wounded at least another 10 or 20 others, and it was a very sad scenario. Another thing that's bringing a lot of, you know, another one of those things bringing a lot of reactionary attention towards the issues of guns and stuff like that, and y'all know my opinions on that, so there's no business for me going into that, and I'm not going to spend an enormous amount of time talking about it. But basically, I had acknowledged that in a video that I put out the other day. But I was going to do an update video on that, but I just didn't, you know, really have enough facts and figures going on that, but I figured I'd probably release another update video like I did for Sac City, and do that. I don't really ever think I did an update video for Delta, for the Delta State University thing either, so I don't know if I'll get around to it with Umpqua or not, but I might just even do a whole collaboration video on the recent school shootings that have happened. There was also a thwarted attack that happened at Somerville High School up in the Northern California foothills just outside of Sacramento. So, yeah, there's been a lot of attention towards that. And then, so I might end up doing a video at some point talking about gun violence, you know, some measures I do believe that should be taken, as well as also reiterating my personal stance on an armed proletariat. So it is one of those things where, yes, I probably will get called a hypocrite by some individuals, even though I'm going to try to keep the level of the aura of hypocrisy to a very acute minimum, but for the most part, I'm going to try to do a video. I think I'm going to try to do a video talking about those issues and trying to engage a discussion about that. And, you know, the topics of guns and stuff like that, much like the topic of religion and the topic of even politics, is a very controversial subject. But it's something that needs to be talked about, and it seriously needs to actually be looked at a rational perspective and not a reactionary one like our society that we live in. That being said, this video is going to focus on more of on actual social nature when it comes down to things. And the reason I wanted to make this video on this was because I haven't really had a really true opinion of it. I've actually gotten into some talks with friends on social media about it, that, you know, where I'm just like, I really don't have an opinion, I don't really actually care about it, or I don't really, you know, blah blah blah, wasn't really interested in it. But I do occasionally still get asked by friends, and I still get asked by fans even, what my opinion on things like Anita Sarkisian and things like that that are in the media. Like, I know I'm really late to this, because this Anita Sarkisian BS has been going on for, like, what, a year or two now? So I know I'm really late to the party jumping in on this, but I always say better late than never, and because if I don't address this, then I, you know, people are going to say, well, you're a hypocrite, blah, 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 because, well, you believe in gender equality, don't you? Well, why not, you know, what? So what's your opinion on Anita Sarkisian? You don't have anything to say about it? Well, you must be a hypocrite because you, blah, 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 blah. So, just to satisfy, you know, that particular set, you know, all sects of the community, my personal opinion on Anita Sarkisian, I don't truly have that much of one. I, to be honest, don't really even care, because I think it's a social justice warrior BS, and just a reactionary sort of thing, you know, and basically something to just cause a reactionary emotion or reactionary sentiment towards it, and even towards gender equality. When it comes down to Anita Sarkisian herself, I agree that there is sexism in gaming. But let me explain why I'm not that interested in it. Because one of my friends said, well, this is something you should be interested in. And no, it's not necessarily something I should. Why? Because I am not a gamer. I've never professed to be one. I will admit right on down to it that I'm a nerd in a lot of other things, but gaming is not one of them. I just have not really had a lot of time to do a lot of gaming and stuff like that. I will pick up a controller every once in a while, check in on new games and stuff like that, but with the cost of consoles and the price of games, it just wasn't worth it. I have a lot more time and money that I would rather invest in more trivial matters that of concern. For instance, I'm active in politics, so I'm, you know, a political activist, I'm a college student. There's a lot more things, more important things I'd rather invest my time and energy and money on. But every once in a while I will pick up a game like Call of Duty. I will pick up Fallout. I can't wait for 4 to come out, to be honest. But when it comes down to the actual topic of gaming, I don't really tend to have much of an opinion on a lot of things, because I don't profess to be a member of that community. I don't claim to be active in that community. And I don't really want to insert myself or really involve myself in that community's affairs. Whatever goes on in that community, they can just hash out pretty much amongst themselves. There are occasions, though, where I do weigh in on things and think, you know, maybe I, you know, there's a few things I could talk about. And when it comes down to Anita Sarkisian, do I believe that there's sexism in gaming? Yes, it's entirely patriarchal. That should be completely obvious. There's lots of female gamers, but it's still, you know, like football, American football, baseball, basketball. It's a very patriarchal society, a very patriarchal world, a very patriarchal community. And, you know, and in general, it can be very sexist. I agree. There's a lot of women that do get sexually harassed. There are women that do get, that, you know, are basically literally chastised and, you know, cyberbullied, frankly. But to go that actually out to the extent that they have, claiming that, you know, that the certain things like that they are their cyber cyber had something to do peg like cyber rape or something like that, like that you, or cyber touch or something like that, saying that it was an, you know, that, you know, the whole thing of was it a good touch or a bad touch sort of cyber touch bullshit, which I think is BS, because, you know, you poke somebody on Facebook that finds it annoying, well, that could be considered a bad touch, that could be considered rape or whatever the case is. Now, I know this is a touchy subject also given the fact that this is coming from a man, but at the same time, also look at my background, look at my track record as far as how I vote, how I've been out in the community, how I put videos on YouTube, the words that I've actually said in the past. My ideology alone, I'm a Marxist-Leninist-Maoist, and part of the key concept of Marxism is that women are our comrades, they are our equals, and they should be treated as such, that they are just as much a part of the fight for the revolutionary struggle as their male counterparts. Because gender equality, gender struggle, is all part of the class struggle, much like race struggle, race issues, racial issues, are part of the class struggle. I mean, and we could go on to other issues of it as well, but I've spoken on this before in my talk about the social construct theory, because essentially that all is where it falls under, is this idea of the social construct. And stereotypically, where men are were considered the dominant creatures, and that women were considered the more, you know, were basically considered, in most cases, were considered subservient. And see that, and that is all part of a very patriarchal social construct, and one that was that basically came about more through the influence of Christianity, through capitalism. We could make a billion and one arguments on all that, but essentially it came through those forms of those forms and ideologies of exploitation. And but the very idea of where Anita Sarkisian and whoever the other fucking chick that, you know, has been running off at the mouth lately, they spoke before the UN and were basically talking about this whole thing about cyber touch and about sexual harassment, sexual violence, and stuff like that, and in cyberland and all that sort of bullshit. And I think, for the most part, I think a lot of that is pure BS. I don't really consider myself to be a radical feminist. I consider myself, in fact, there was once a time where I considered myself a feminist, but I not disenfranchised or distanced myself, but I didn't really like the word, because I thought it, not because I didn't like being called a feminist or being labeled as a feminist or even identifying as a feminist, it's because I thought it was awful redundant. Because the whole concept of gender equality, gender struggle, is part of the class struggle, part of the revolutionary struggle. And I think that true feminism, true gender equality can be derived and can be, and the equality, gender equality can be achieved through the revolutionary struggle. The problem is, in the first world, is that we don't have this tendency to want to do revolution. We want to have concessions done, these reforms. And then that's where a lot of this BS like Anita Sarkisian and social justice warrioring basically comes into play. And that is essentially what she is. And I hate to actually say this, but that is what Anita Sarkisian is. She's a social justice warrior. That's what her friend is. And while they do make some good points on certain things, you know, especially when it concerns the gaming about sexual harassment and just harassment in general, even cyberbullying, I agree, there's a lot of that that does occur. There are women that are victims of that. But to say that women are basically targets of sexual violence or some sort of form of sexual abuse, you know, is really kind of asinine, I think. Not that I'm saying that it probably doesn't happen, but the likelihood and the percentage that it probably does happen just seems so unlikely and just so minuscule compared to, you know, compared to a woman that's out there who is more likely to be raped by someone she knows than from someone that she, you know, basically is communicating through Call of Duty or something like that, and the person lives like 3,000 miles away, you know, that person is probably not that big of a threat to you. But the person that is your best friend or something like that, who you think is your best friend, you know, he's trying to get at you, and you get drunk at a party one night, and then he forces himself on you. I'm not trying to scare anybody here, but you know, if we're going to talk about that, let's be brutally honest. That guy, you know, did something that is wrong, and I am personally a believer that when a woman is drunk, she is not in a consensual state of mind, you know. But you know, it also, but then, you know, that brings up a whole lot of issues. Well, how drunk is drunk, and blah blah blah, you know. And we could go doing a dance around that the whole damn night. But you know, broad basic sense is that, you know, that is a more common occurrence. And that is more of a, that would be more of a common occurrence that would occur, especially in the college atmosphere, and probably even in the high school atmosphere, but definitely more in the college atmosphere. And, you know, so I do take the issue of sexual violence very seriously, and I take the issue of, you know, women being abused, especially domestic violence and everything else, I take that very seriously because of something that happened in my own personal life, that happened to my own family. And so that's why I really take those issues very seriously. It's also, you know, I also have a very, but I've had those views for a long time because ideologically these are the views that I hold. And so yeah, I agree on certain things that Sarkisian talks about, but over the last year or so, in fact, I literally went from being a person that was a supporter of Anita Sarkisian, because I did kind of keep up with it to an extent. Then I did some digging. I actually started listening to more of what she was saying, and she really goes off the radical tirade on a lot of things, to the point where I just, a lot of the things, especially lately, that she said, I just cannot take seriously. I would like to be able to take her more seriously, but there's just a lot of things that she says that go so far off the cuff that it's hard to really support that, because I really do believe that she is more of a social justice warrior, and I'm sorry, but I just don't like to take those people very seriously. There's a point where social justice is okay, but let's be honest, social justice is a very bourgeois liberal concept that begs for concessions, begs for reforms and revisions, and it doesn't do really anything to challenge the status, it challenges the status quo, but it doesn't challenge the system that the status quo perpetrates. So it doesn't really do anything to challenge the capitalist authority. It doesn't really do anything to challenge that, you know, the system that is causing all this BS in the first place. That's why I always say the only real way to achieve gender equality is revolution. And that's why I say that's where it becomes more of a focus in trying to achieve equality, through breaking down that social barrier, to break down the systemic barrier that's causing all this in the first place. And that means tearing down capitalism itself, because you can get all the reforms you want, you can get bits and pieces of equality as time goes on, but that bits and pieces will eventually be eroded away in some fashion, because that is the nature of capitalism. And you know, you could get all the concessions you want, but it's really not going to achieve anything, because if you really want that change to be long lasting, to be, you know, perpetual, then you're going to have to actually tear down that system. you know, it, and regardless, it's always going to be a fight in some case. You're either going to be constantly battling the capitalist system, you know, that you're going to be constantly battling the capitalist class who's in, who's ruling over you. You're going to be constantly fighting this continuous, you know, this continuous circle with them, this dance around the fucking fire, or we're going, or you achieve revolution, and then you're trying to do whatever you can to prevent that ruling class from getting back to power, because then you, because you are then in that position of power, and you can prevent anybody from sabotaging it. And ultimately, that's the goal, is to prevent, is to prevent sabotage, because the ruling class is always going to try to, the capitalist class is always going to try to do something to sabotage any sort of progress, because, you know, they don't want progress. They don't want, they don't like the idea of having to give up any sort of power. So, you know, whether you have to achieve some sort of equality by taking a little bit of that power away from them, or taking it completely away from them and putting yourself in a position of power, is when, you know, it, yeah, you're going to be doing some sort of dance. But it's better to do that dance and be in a position of power, to be a to be part of that, the dictatorship of the proletariat, than to be having to be subjected to this servitude under capitalism. I don't know if this is making any sense to people, but that's essentially what I'm getting at. So, yeah, that's why I'm saying that the social justice warrior bullshit, it doesn't, I don't really consider it to work. It'll get concessions, it'll do that sort of BS, but it's not really going to do anything to challenge anything. And really, all it's really doing is harming the gender equality movement than it actually is helping. And I'm sorry to have to be the, you know, be the asshole to point that out, but it really does. I mean, Anita Sarkisian, she could be a great role model for gender equality if she wasn't such a radical, you know, social, if she wasn't such a social justice warrior about it. She, I mean, it's one thing to be a radical feminist, it's one thing to be a feminist in general. When you start basically getting to the point where you're that chick that's almost got the fucking butcher knife in her hand, that's when you start to lose a lot of credibility, when you start to lose a lot of the, that, that, you start to lose a lot of that sort of aura about you that, you know, that basically has people taking you seriously. And that's why, that's why there's such this push by a lot of people, and a lot of people not even taking the feminist movement seriously, because everybody thinks that feminists are just, you know, these, you know, they think that it's not about equality for women, that it's not about equality at all, that they think that, you know, it's all just a bunch of, you know, crazy, like, Xena warrior princess sort of people, and it's really not. It's not that, feminism is not even about that. Feminism is actually about equality. It is about achieving gender struggle, but the problem is that a lot of feminists go through it in such a bourgeois liberal way that it doesn't really do anything. And so I really think that if there was more of a focus on trying to achieve better means of it, then maybe I could kind of, you know, support Anita Sarkisian. But she just goes completely apeshit with a lot of the things that she says, and it's just really hard for me to take that serious. But one of the things that I tend to also argue is definitely in favor of gender equality, because, you know, it's those people that say, well, that feminism is not about equality, gender equality is not really about equality, you know. And then you have these people like the men's rights movement that fucking comes about, and I can't fucking take the men's rights movement seriously either, because most of the men's rights movement, their whole movement is essentially all based on ad hominem, it's all based on straw mans, and it's primarily based on a lot of red herrings as well. I mean, it's literally a movement Not that there isn't some sort of credibility, and I can understand a little bit about the MRM, but for the most part, they're very... A lot of the things that they go about trying to argue is there's so many strawmans that go about in that. There's so many... and there is so many ad hominems, because most of their arguments against feminism is all attacking... is all attacking character and all attacking and credibility and stuff like that, and it's which, and even when they try to attack credibility, they strawman. Their points are based on so many illogical fallacies, and it's just like, in some ways I really do say that the MRM, I don't really believe they have much credibility at all. I hate to say that. I hate to be the asshole that says that, but it's true. The MRM does not really have, in my mind at least, it does not have a whole lot of credibility. And you can call me biased because of my own, you know, personal feelings and stuff like that towards men, but it's... But, you know, it's has a lot more to do with the fact that they don't really... That the men's rights movement does not advocate equality. Men's rights movement is all about the patriarchy. It's all about trying to maintain their privilege and stuff like that they already have. It's not about achieving equality. Men already have privilege. Especially if you're a white male, and a white male Christian for that matter, you have plenty of privilege. You know, but men in general have a large level of privilege in society over women, and they have had pretty much that, you know, for most of history. I mean, pretty much since the time that Christianity and capitalism basically took over, it's, you know, men have had substantial levels of privilege. They've typically been the landowners, they've been the breadwinners, they've been, their role is typically, you know, where they were the ones that provided for the family, where the woman, and the woman was subservient to the man because she was forced to take care of children, to, you know, to cook and to clean and blah, blah, blah. And that's not how it's supposed to be. Women are under at least Marxist theory, women are supposed to be our comrades. They're supposed to be our equals. And if you are a revolutionary who also identifies with the men's rights movement, you are not a revolutionary. Because the whole idea is that we treat women as our equals, as our comrades, and not only that, are trying to achieve, they're helping to achieve the gender struggle through the form of class struggle. Because obviously gender struggle is a product of the class struggle. Because, you know, as I've said before, you can't really have one without the other. And so it's all about trying to... It does all come down to that whole idea that you can't be a socialist or a communist or Marxist or revolutionary, whatever you want to say. You can't be revolutionary if you are part of the men's rights movement. Because the men's rights movement is not revolutionary. It is actually reactionary. Is counter-revolution. It's counter-revolutionary. And so, to those of you that are watching this video, especially friends of mine, I'm sorry, but I personally don't consider you revolutionary if you're part of the MRM. And, like I said, men already have a level of privilege in this country. That, not even in this country, in society in general, and this, you know, they have a certain, quite a lot, a level of privilege. I mean, when you do consider that 75, that to every dollar a man makes, is, you know, a woman gets 75 cents, that's kind of one of the things that is a thing that goes against it. And of course, people try to debunk that, and it's all based on BS arguments, because the statistics are as proven. And so it is this whole idea that it's trying to deny that these certain things exist, trying to say that women already have equality, that they already have certain levels of this. And that it's like none of these people provide me with legitimate arguments, with legitimate facts on that, because the facts that they do provide are so skewed and flawed that it's absolutely ridiculous. So it's, and the, what I'm really getting at here is the fact that men, whether you want to believe it or not, whether the MRMs want to believe it or not, men have privilege. Men have a substantial level of privilege compared to women. And that's why a lot of, you know, even though there are people like Anita Sarkisian that don't really get gender equality taken seriously, it, you know, it's one of those things where women do, they don't have, they do not have this, you know, the same privilege, the same equality as men do. And that is essentially why gender equality exists, why revolutionaries continue to fight for females' equality. If you actually believe that that females already have equality, then explain the war on women, such as people like Ted Cruz and other assholes that try to circumvent this sort of BS, and, you know, try to say that, that women should not have the right to that women should not have the right to choose, that the life of this cluster of fucking cells is more important than the life of a woman that already exists. You know, and I love those MRMs that claim, you know, that claim, oh yeah, men, it's like men are just fighting for our equality too, because, you know, blah blah blah, you know, women already have equality, and then they're also pro-choice. So explain to me why you're fighting for women's rights, you know, in that aspect, because let's be honest, pro-choice is pro-women's rights. Why are you went for a woman's rights? Why are you fighting for something that a woman should already have if you already claim that women have those rights, have equal rights? Answer me that. That's what I seriously want to know, because that sounds a little hypocritical. So that's why I always make that, this is why I make these sorts of arguments, because the logic of the MRM, of the men's rights movement, is extremely fucking flawed. So it's that's why I can't take it seriously. It's full of ad hominem. They're constantly attacking people's character and credibility. They're actually doing nothing to actually argue the point. They're constantly begging the question about different, you know, on different arguments. They, you know, and it, you can literally ask them something and it ends up going around in circles. And then, at least half of their arguments are all based in straw manning. And I just don't fucking, I just can't take that movement seriously. And they, and I mean, their whole idea is that men are trying to achieve some sort of level of, that they're trying to get some level of equality. No, what you're trying to do is keep this ruling class privilege, basically trying to keep the status quo as it is. You're basically trying to, you're actually circumventing women's rights in the process. I mean, the whole, as I said, it's that whole thing where it comes down to MRMs who are pro-choice, which I give a pretty firm example when it comes down to, like, Republicans who claim that they're pro-life, but then send, you know, young men and women off to war and have them die for their fucking imperialist causes. Or even when those people get back, do survive, and they get back from these wars, that suddenly, once they become civilians again, or veterans of the military, suddenly they don't mean jack shit. But, you know, it has nothing to, you know, their idea that they're pro-life has nothing to do with life. It's all so that they can, you know, basically exploit that, exploit something for their own benefit, and for most likely their own profit. And it's the same with the men's rights movement. So it's, you know, it really jostle my jimmies in a way when this whole issue comes about, because the whole because the men's rights movement is hypocritical in a lot of cases. So, yeah, I that's where I personally stand on the whole issue right there. It's just, I don't really see a point in it. I don't really see the point. I really don't see the point in Anita Sarkisian's arguments as much as I do the men's rights movement, because in both cases, there are people that are committing ad hominem, they're strawmanning, they're attacking, you know, people and stuff like that, in all to exploit their own interests and stuff like that. Essentially, I would, as much as I hate to say it, Anita Sarkisian is kind of the men's rights movement of the feminist movement. And I really can't, and so it's one of those things where she really does not, where neither one, I think, has that much credibility, nor do I think that they really should be taken seriously or really given any sort of, you know, any sort of real recognition. There's some things that sometimes I think that Anita Sarkisian says that, again, that I do agree with, but there's not a lot. There's not a whole lot of substance to her arguments. You know, and so that's why I really can't take her seriously. But it is one of those things I had to bring up the issue about the men's rights movement as well, because the men's rights movement is always claiming, you know, that they're trying to achieve certain equal rights when they already have privilege, and all that gender equality is trying to do, that, and certain feminists as well try to do, is trying to attain that equality. And in Marxism, that's why we have that professional level of gender equality within our own movements, because we're trying to achieve, an equal footing for women, and essentially is for women's rights. And of course we do believe that we need to achieve that through revolution, and frankly, let's be honest, women should have an equal footing in everything. So, but all the men's rights movement does is try to stifle that and hold back progress. And that's not revolutionary. So, anyway, this is going to be a short video. I wanted to put my thoughts and figures out on that. My views when it comes down to Anita Sarkisian, I don't really care. I've been told by people I should care, because blah blah blah, men's rights BS, blah blah blah, and that, you know, that she's a, that somehow she's a threat to some sort of thing. Anita Sarkisian's not so much a threat. She's, if anything, she's just a reactionary. She is definitely a bourgeois liberal social justice warrior who's got her head up her ass at the most. You know, I do believe, you know, she has some good points when it comes down to women actually in gaming itself, that there is sexism and blah 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 involved. But the way that she's gone so far with it is just completely defeats her purpose of anything at all. So, I think that if she was more level-headed and actually focused more on the issue of sexism in gaming, then we could actually have a logistical and logical argument. But, you know, she's taken it so far to an extreme that it's gotten out of hand, and that I personally think that there's many other people out there that are better suited to talk about this than she is. So, yeah, I don't really, that's as far as I really can get on her about certain individuals like her. That's where I stand, because, and again, it doesn't really affect my community as much, so I don't really worry about it. So I don't really care about that. And I do believe that women do need to be treated a little bit more fairly when it comes to gaming. I think that, you know, because gaming is, let's be honest, it's a sport, and it's a patriarchal sport. It's a patriarchal sport. And there needs to be some challenge to that patriarchal structure. But that's really as far as my views go on it. And as far as, you know, the men's rights movement, I think that the men's rights movement stifles progress and is actually more reactionary and counter-revolutionary. And I would be so bold as to even say I would find it more along the lines of libertarianism and conservatism than I would anything in the bourgeois liberal or even revolutionary sect. Which also brings up that argument that if you are men's rights movement, but also claiming to be revolutionary, you are a complete contradiction. Because if you actually believe in Marxism and Marxist science and everything else, you would be in favor of gender equality. But unfortunately, if you're going to get behind a reactionary movement like MRM, then you have no place in the revolutionary business. To even call yourself a revolutionary is an insult to Marxists, and it is an insult to Marxism itself. It's an insult to Karl Marx himself. It's an insult to any revolutionary that has ever existed. So, that's what I wanted to basically talk about for this week's video. I expect this to get a lot of flack from both sides of both sides. I expect a lot of pissed off rad fans to get mad at me, and I expect a lot of angry fucking men's rights movement people to be after me. But the people that this video will actually appeal probably more to is the middle ground, to those bourgeois liberals that are not social justice warriors that can actually understand my points, and do revolutionaries who understand my personal way of thinking as well. And as I've said already, I don't care what the haters have to say anymore, because really I don't give a fuck. They are actually some of my best critics, and they still give me those views anyway. So, you know, I mean, the very fact that they take the time to watch my video or comment, they're still giving it time. You know, whereas they could just on most cases bugger off. But, you know, I give people ample opportunity to comment to me whether they like my videos or not. And as I said, what I'm doing here is making content that I want to do, that my audience wants me to do, and that I think that my audience will enjoy. So I'm going to keep doing videos like this. I'm going to continue doing what I have been doing. And if you don't like what I have to say, I'm not sorry for it. And you know what? That's another thing. I'm done saying I'm sorry, and I'm done apologizing for people getting butthurt over what I have to say. I'm not going to be apologizing for anything anymore. Occasionally, I may apologize for exceeding my own position and being extreme and exceedingly arrogant. But essentially, I'm done apologizing for people getting butthurt. And I'm not going to be apologizing for that anymore. And for this personal video right here, if you have a problem with it, tough tankies. I'm NorCal Nick, leader of the revolutionist movement, and this has been NorCal Corner. Peace, y'all.